What is up? My name is Tony and I am a filmmaker, photographer in St. Louis, Missouri. Today we are hanging out at the park. It is a beautiful day. We've had just a couple weeks that have been unbelievable. It went from like 35 to like 80 degrees almost overnight, and sunny skies, beautiful. The trees are just starting to turn. And I figured it's probably time that I do another video on kind of a cinematic B-roll of the season. And I figured this time I would do a similar one to what we typically do, but I'm gonna mix it up just a little bit. Let me show you the setup. All right, well, we're still gonna be using the 5D Mark IV for the video today. We'll be shooting in C-Log. And if you'll notice though, we're gonna be shooting on a 100 millimeter. And that's technically a telephoto. And the reason why is because I was scrolling through Facebook, and in the Ronin S group that I'm in on Facebook, somebody asked the question, can I just see a 70 to 200 balanced on a Ronin? And there was so much hate on it about using a telephoto with a handheld gimbal. And so I just wanted to show you the difference between some of my other 5D Mark IV videos that I used a 35 millimeter with versus the 100 millimeter telephoto. I'll probably use some of the macro just because it's already on there and it looks so cool. Another thing you'll notice is we've got the ND filter. That's just a 67 millimeter filter with variable settings. So other than that, we're using the Ronin S and we're just gonna see what we can do. So, all right, here we go.
New to me, the way that you're moving so differently. Now this is all I want. So if you make a move, I promise I'll be there too. Give me time and place, you know. I will be there before you have to wait for me. Been hiding away for too long. Cause all I need is something just like this in the time and place. Ooh, nah. Give me a time and
we ran out of light very fast. Oh well, I think I still got some usable shots. But you can see the difference between the 35mm, which is a super versatile lens. You can get beautiful portraits, you can get up close, you can get far away. I love using a 35 on a gimbal, but also when you're using a telephoto lens like an 85 or 100mm, you get that huge blurry background because the background is really far away. Put your subject close and you get just blown out beautiful backgrounds. Then when you start adding movement into that, when you start spinning around, you get this huge movement within your film. So I think personally there's tons of reasons to use a telephoto lens on a handheld gimbal. It is harder, you have to be more smooth because you can see every little tiny imperfection, but when you practice and you get better, I guarantee you, you'll be so happy with these results. I'd suggest using a 100 millimeter, like I said, an 85 millimeter, I use that a lot. Any telephoto lens is fine. Just crank that sucker out and see what you can do. So, cool? All right, hopefully this video helped. Subscribe if you haven't already. Like this video if it's helped you so that others can see it on YouTube. And comment if you have any questions or if you have anything else to add. Thanks guys, take care, see you next week.